Giroud
will
be gone at the end of the season.
Nothing.
Yeah.
Oh, it was really bad. Terrible capitulation, and that's the thing. I think that most Arsenal fans are upset about is that we capitulated, and that's three times in a row we've done it. At City, we've done it. Liverpool. I actually think today's one was worse. Obviously, we're playing against Chelsea. We want to beat Chelsea. It's Arsene Wenger's 1,000th game, so the players should be out there fighting for their lives. And I just felt that, listen, it happens in football. You can go 2-0 down, but then after that, you've got to fight. And I just felt that we just capitulated after that, and we shouldn't be coming here and losing 6-0. We're a better team than that. And it was a very poor performance by Arsenal, and we've got to do better.
We asked it before about lacking leaders in the team, but no one performed for you today, and no one sort of looked like they wanted to get that team back in the game,
they looked a bit shell shocked. I don't know if it's these early kickoffs because every time we got an early kickoff, and we always get smashed. We had an early kickoff against City, early kickoff against early kickoff against Liverpool. It's these early kickoffs that we've been doing it. No, I mean, it's not acceptable because, Arsenal are a big club, right? Arsenal are a bigger club than Chelsea. You saw our fans today. They're still right behind the team, but we've got to do better than this. And I just feel a bit sorry for Arsene Wenger in this 1,000th game. You know, to have all the Chelsea fans singing, "We want you to stay," and things like that, taking the mick. I mean, it was poor by us, and they let him down today.
I'm not an Arsenal fan, but I'm looking in. I look at Wenger and I think, like Mourinho, if things aren't going right, he'll make three changes straight away, he'll be up there, he'll be rollicking them. Wenger just sat there and looked
at I don't know.
Do you think Arsenal have options?
We are sort of down to the bare bones at the moment with the squad. I mean, we've got key players missing. I mean, Chelsea wouldn't be the same if they had Hazard, John Terry, etc. missing out of the team. There's not a lot you can call on the bench. Remember, we were 2-0 down, so I wouldn't make changes at 2-0 down. It was only about 10 minutes gone. Even Mourinho wouldn't have made changes then. And then we're down to 10 men. So then you're limited immediately. So there are a lot of fans blaming Wenger. I don't think you can blame Wenger for that. I mean, no team in the Premier League is supposed to lose by 6. No team. Not Arsenal, not Norwich, not any team near the bottom. You're not supposed to lose 6-0. If you get beaten 6-0, the players need to look at themselves. So I don't know. And I still love Arsene Wenger. He's been working with... You know, he's come out even this week and he's admitted that, you know, over the past few years he's had to work with limited funds. It's only now he's starting to get a bit of money. I'm going to be very interested to see what he does in the summer, now that he's got money to spend. I mean, Jose Mourinho is a great manager, but let's face it, he works on a lot of this. Yeah, he works on a lot of money. I would love to see him work on a squad where he'd have, say, limited funds. And that's not taking anything away from him as a manager, he's a great manager, but he works with big funds. He did it in Milan with big funds, he did it here with big funds. You know, he wouldn't have come back here if Abramovich said, yeah, there's going to be no money to spend. So
what happens now if you ever forbid you don't win the FA Cup?
It's not a given that we're going to win the FA Cup.
No, you're probably the favourites now, you have to say.
Of course we're the favourites to win the FA Cup, and I think we will win the FA Cup.
I'm not trying to pull more majority on
What happens if the Ukrainians and that in Russia and that kicks off and take your money out of Chelsea.
I'm not on the back of the 6-0 loss, so I'm trying to make
it. I'm asking you that. What happens if the situation in Ukraine gets worse and the government starts to put pressure on Abramovich?
For want of a more eloquent answer, we're fucked.
On a serious note, listen, I think he does need to win something this year. the pressure is mounting on Arsene Wenger, and it's sad that we're talking about that today because it's 1,000 games that he's managed, and for any manager to achieve that is amazing. So listen,
it totally is, but what I would say is games like this, you remember longer than...
I remember 49 games unbeaten.
I remember that.
Something you guys have never done. I remember that more done. I remember going a whole season unbeaten more than this. I'll forget about this next week if we win our next two games. I'll forget about this. If we actually got to the end of the season and won the title, I won't remember this. If we get to the end of the season and we don't win the title and we finish out of the top four, I'll remember this. That's football.